from that commercial break. You're still watching Salute Talk, and I'm your girl, Savara Huza. Today, what a topic, I know you guys are wondering, why revenge sex? Why would we have to categorize? If you didn't understand from the beginning, revenge sex is a very, it falls under the topic of sex, but it's a very big concept on its own. So we're gonna be bisecting a little bit on what exactly, what some of the causes, what are some of the problems, and then later we shall have the effects, positive or negative. When we're doing our kinda, let's say they may not be, they are positive effects. That's how I stand straight. Anyway, before we went for the commercial break, we were gonna hear from the lovely lady herself some of the causes why someone would opt for revenge sex. Hey, we shall come to mind, but let us pass the paresis.
Well, I think some of the reasons that somebody would have revenge sex, personally, I wouldn't do that. I swear, I would not. I swear,
even
I wouldn't.
Thank you.
I swear, upon the death of my parents, I wouldn't do revenge sex.
Thank you.
I wouldn't do revenge sex. Do you know why? It doesn't yield to nothing. Maybe self-satisfaction, but these are the...
Hold on.
Do you know why people have revenge sex?
No. Why?
I think it's because of ego, number one, and it's because of selfishness. People are selfish. People out there want to satisfy their own, you know, souls, their own selves. You know, they want to show people that I'm big and you're small, up and you're down, you know. And like I said, in most cases, it doesn't yield to anything. But then I think it's most likely brought about by men. Abasajja, they push us to the core. A man can push you to the core. I'm telling you men,
but you can push
us to the core. This is how it goes. You'll be with a man for years, let's say 3 years, and he won't, there was a point when they reach and they are not satisfied with their sex anymore. And they won't tell you.
They'll just go
ahead and start playing you around behind your back just to satisfy themselves. And then whenever you catch them red-handed, they'll never admit
that fact.
They'll always deny. And this brings that ego in you to retaliate. You're like, what can I do to him?
Let me try to
He just cheated. I need to do something. Like, what can I do? And he'll always want you to feel hurt, but he won't want you to go ahead and also do the same thing with somebody else. So I don't know what's wrong with you guys, but you really need to have a self-check.
Now, let me tell you something, yeah? What we've read the overly sexual.
Truth.
And I don't believe you're sane enough, yeah, to have sex because of someone.
Because someone has, like,
hurt you or whatever the case.
Yeah.
Hold on. I believe in rebound sex. I believe in satisfaction sex. I'm not good in bed, yeah. And you feel like, okay, when I talk to him, I respect that. You can go and sleep with whoever you want to sleep with, okay, in your time. That's, you can be sane, you want to be happy as well. You don't want to be in prison or in a corner, you're complaining, you're not happy, yeah? When you wake up, you're having sex to hurt me, you're depressed, you're insane, you have a low self-esteem.
You're sick.
Most men
do these things because maybe you're not supporting me financially.
Maybe I can sleep with your friend. I can meet you. No, let's actually, I sleep with her. Okay, wow, okay, I like her. Listen. Singana soka lava, that's not revenge sex.
No, and you go ahead and tell her that Paris Tower. When I'm with other people, they tell me I'm the sweetest thing around. Those are the mistakes they make. You tell your side chick, Paris Tower, I've been with her for around this time, but I feel like, Taina Waka. Taina Waka, and this is the person you run back to whenever Olimu injury.
Let me tell you something, yeah? You can't tell me you're having sex to hurt me. Because let me give you a scenario, yeah? Nzenganze, I personally, I believe sex is something, chocola, not just for just.
Not just for just, yeah.
Oh, you say it,
True.
not just for just. Nashitagera. Inze nganze. Rachi, I see that in a different perspective, yeah? When I break up with you, yeah? No agenda. You just keep quiet. You do your thing. Or you know that I cheated on you and stuff.
And
I said this and this. You give me space. You just be in your lane. Yeah? That would hurt me. Like deep, deep, real hurt. I'll be like, oh, my mariat, yeah. Even if they meet you somewhere, they're like, hey, banange, hey, we met Paris. Ah, Timori would have been one in Naku. Paris, I Even if, listen to me. Even if I've taken months or without checking your Facebook or IG, I'll go and check. Eh, banga mbeno Paris ya kolachi, anyirira. It would haunt me down. Oshitegera, ngachima iti watuwa sidikatu wa kolachi. But, you see, listen, we together, we break up, you sleep with him, eh? Nenchimanya, you, neweba kana, and I get to know that you slept with my friend. Ne wane high five, nengenda nenyuamu, nenchakala, nengamba naona kachere.
No, perhaps.
Because you're stupid.
No, yeah. You're forgetting I'm that fact.
Because I know, naona katala, naona psycho.
No, listen, he's forgetting the fact that perhaps I don't want to get back with him. As long as much as we broke up, I'm happy. Do you know why people glow after breakups? Have you seen Mickey Wine's wife?
No, listen to me. There is someone.
Because she's been going through a lot.
No, listen to me. No, first wait.
Your glow. Do you know she has been pouring into an empty cup?
A woman only glows. No, you can only glow when you're not stressed.
No,
but if you're having revenge sex, I'm in your mind, I'm killing you, I'm deep down inside you, I'll celebrate.
Okay, let me tell you something, guys. Do you know there are moments where you feel you've been pouring into a cup that's not pouring into yours? So you just feel you need a positive vibe. You need like a rebirth. You need to become yourself.
Then that's
once
rebound
again.
Sex. Because
no, it's
listen
not
to
rebound
me.
Sex.
You can be with me. You can be with me. He has everything. He's handsome. Like he's rich. No. Yeah. No.
Listen.
No, Kachere because he's taking my woman. Naye ngakule bubi and you're not into him. Okay, you can be into him, but you're like, okay, I have my Timo.
Yeah, banga, he's good.
Timo is not perfect. Timo is stupid and what? But let me be here with my guy. When we break up, and you genuinely go and sleep with that person, that's not revenge sex.
Do you know that
it might hurt me? But that's not revenge sex.
Do you know that
to you,
mental health
you,
is real?
That is rebound sex.
No,
but wokera ngakumacha. To have sex with someone, to hurt another person, you need a medical check.
No, these things are not good. Eh? The sex, whatever we are talking about, it's not actually good. But it's treating people's mental health.
No, that's not treatment.
It's treating people's mental
health. That's not treatment.
You know what, guys? Let me first pause you there a bit. Because if I'm talking mid-speed, I'm even losing where we are. Okay, no, what he's talking about is very right. Rebound sex. But like I said from the beginning, sex is sex.
It's sex.
Whether revenge, whether I've just gone for one coming at Inkomiewo, whether I've just gone just to explore, it is still sex, regardless, right? So, revenge sex. I'm not going to be an expert, and neither are we experts. We're only talking about our opinions to eat. There is someone also out there who's watching who's like, it's this, it's that. So, obviously, we are only going to talk about our personal opinions to eat and, like, you know, come to like a conclusion. but I'm going to agree with you on one thing. People who are, if, let me say, like you told her, if she has sex, if she's dating with you, and you guys break up or have an argument and she sleeps with your friend. Now that also means
I would celebrate that.
Why would you celebrate
you're sick.
That?
You're mentally sick. But nakuona.
Why would you call someone mentally sick?
Because
let me give you a scenario. Before we go, let me give you a scenario. Let me say you're dating with someone. Let me say you and Paris are dating. You've dated for over 2 years now. You stay in the same house, you share everything, same bed sheet, almost even the same sponge sometimes. And then, you guys, you know, because obviously we are human beings, we cannot all be perfect. I cannot expect you to know exactly what I want, but I expect you to try to know what I want. If I told you are in a relationship with me, that's where most people come wrong. Now, the scenario is this. You guys are dating, you've been together for some good time, and you can call yourselves lovers, partners. Like, you're sharing things and now you're partners. And then, some of the issues between you guys, let me say one, sexually, she has been complaining, or you're not bad, but you're not as good as she wants you to be. You understand what I mean? You're not bad, but you're not as good as she wants you to be. So you guys have talked about this, and she feels like she's tired of talking. She has talked enough, and you are not showing that you are trying. Like she said, pouring in someone's cup, you're pouring, but no one is pouring for you. So your cup remains empty while the other person's cup gets filled. So why don't you try? That's what men don't understand these days. Men, our Sajia, by the way, they have this excuse. But for us men, we do not know how to handle our emotions. We're never taught.
Uh-huh, exactly. You know? So this brings us to the selfishness I was talking about. Even after a breakup, they expect us to keep cool. That's what he was trying to say. Oh, you just go and keep quiet. I'll come looking for you on Insta, WhatsApp.
So I do it in your face.
And you know these things, that's what I was saying before. They somehow treat people. People have issues. People have mental health issues. So if a way out is to go and sleep it off, please do that. Do that and your soul is full. You come back energized. You get back to work and you'll do that.
So you practically feel that when you do it outside, it's the best way to cool it off. That's what you practically think?
You know what, guys?
I'm giving you a scenario when we are broken. We've already broken up.
Let us pause on that. Sorry, my bosses are calling. Let us go for a short commercial break. When we come back, Paris, you have to start today. I'm not going to introduce the show. When we come back, Tanikira, whoa, because we want to hear this part. Let us go for a short commercial break. When we come back, we still have more for you.